Hi guys, and welcome back to my channel. Today I am doing my favorites video. I guess like my September favorites and like end of summer favorites. And I'm sitting on my bed, which is my favorite place. So I'm just gonna get started because I have like a whole bunch of stuff here. I have like hair stuff, skin stuff, and makeup. I'm also gonna throw in a few of my favorite songs right now. So I'm gonna start with makeup. First is the Velour Fluff and Wispies lashes. They are the lashes that I have on right now. They're super fluffy. They are silk lashes, and they are my absolute favorite lashes. I don't buy them all the time because they are like $26 or $28, but these are definitely my favorite when I want to buy a lash like that. Then I have some eyeshadow palettes. I have one that's really expensive and one that's really affordable. So my first one would be the Morphe Jaclyn Hill palette. You get all these colors. I think it's $38. It's like a favorite of so many people. I find myself grabbing this all the time. It really is one of my all-time favorite palettes. I just think the quality is really good and the color scheme and color selection is really good because you get all the neutrals, the brown neutrals, the reds, and then like a few pops of color over here. So I think it's really useful and really good for $38. And then my other favorite that I've been wearing a lot is the Natasha Denona Sunset palette, which does retail for $129. I do have this one, and I have the Lila palette. I think that they're both incredible. This is the gold that I have on today. It is a lot of money. It is, like, total investment, but twice a year Sephora does the VIB sale, where you could get, like, some people get 15% off, some people get 20. That's when I got mine, when it was 20 off. And I just think that the quality is there. So if you were ever curious about if these are worth it, I totally think so. I've never tried the $200-something ones. I've tried these, and I've tried the $50 ones. So I really think that these are worth it. Maybe not for everyone, but I really love this. Moving on, I have a face powder, which is from e.l.f. This is from their Beautifully Bare line. It's kind of dirty, but mine's in the color light medium. I think they only have like fair light and light medium, but this works for me because it's just like a finishing powder, and it's just a really finely milled setting powder. Sets my makeup. It doesn't make my skin look dry at all. I don't look cakey, and I really like that because it sets my makeup so that my bronzer doesn't look patchy or anything, but it doesn't dry out my skin like some bronzers. Like some powders. Moving on, I have a blush, a bronzer, and a highlighter. Both the bronzer and highlighter are from Anastasia. So the bronzer, this is the powder bronzer in the shade Mahogany. It's kind of red based. I really, really like the color of it. It doesn't pull orange at all. It is the bronzer that I have on now. I don't have that much of it on right now, but it's like my favorite bronzer, especially while I was tan. It didn't look muddy. I'm still pretty tan, but when I was like my darkest, it didn't look muddy. It didn't look weird. It's just a really good blendable bronzer. And then highlighter, still my favorite highlighter is the Anastasia Amorese. My best friend, she comes over all the time, gets ready here all the time, and every time she asks me, do you have that highlighter? Or she'll ask me to like give her this highlighter while she's getting ready. So this is, I guess, our favorite highlighter right now. This has been my favorite for a long time. It's just like a good go-to highlighter. I always know that it's gonna look good, and sometimes when you get ready like and do your makeup every day, some days you just need something that you know is gonna look good, and that is this for me. For blush, the blush that I've been grabbing so often is the Morphe Blush Trio. This is in Pop of Rose. This middle one is really similar to NARS Orgasm, and then you have like a really neutral one and then a little bit of a deeper one that I think I'm really gonna like for fall. I just really like these. They're like $12 or so, and I just think three colors for $12 are a really good deal, and they work really well. Other face products. My favorite foundation, my go-to foundation for a while now, and I don't know, I just can't see myself not using this in the months to come. Like, I might have to get a lighter shade, but this is the Clinique Beyond Perfecting foundation and concealer. This one's in 18 Sand. It's just a really good foundation. It has like one of these huge applicators. But it's just a really, really good foundation. It's not overly dewy. It's not matte. It's just, it kind of looks like your skin. And I just really like the finish that it gives. I really like the look that it gives. I just think that it's a solid go-to foundation. And I don't think that it's that much. I think it's like in the $26, $27 range, which for a higher-end foundation is not that much. Some of them are $40, $50. I have Giorgio Armani foundation that's $60-something dollars. So $27, $28, whatever it is. Isn't that bad for this, and I've had this bottle for a while and it has not run out on me. Then for concealer, I love Shape Tape. I absolutely love Shape Tape, but lately I have been using the MAC Studio Fix 24-Hour Smooth Wear Concealer, and it's just like a typical concealer, but it is so creamy and blends so nice, and it's got like a little bit of a luminosity. So it doesn't look dry at all. I've worn it for long periods of time and it just looks good all day. It is such a nice consistency. It's such a good, like, it's such a good concealer. It is right up there with me for Shape, right up there for me with Shape Tape. For primer, my go-to lately has been the PR Form 1 Correcting Primer. It's just like a kind of moisturizing primer. It kind of looks like a moisturizer. It's just white. It does kind of have a little bit of a luminosity, and for me with dry skin, that's really nice to have. It just makes my skin look healthy before makeup, and you know, just preps my skin really nice, and I really like the way that it works. It says energize and rescue. I don't know if it prolongs the wear of my makeup. I don't really have a problem with makeup wearing off that much, but it does really prep my skin really nicely for makeup. Then for brows, I have two products that I've been really liking. First is the Brow Contour Pro by Benefit. So it's kind of like the clicky pen type deal. So it's kind of like a clicky pen that you just click up and down. It looks like one of the like multicolored pens that you used to use probably. And then the Busy Gal Brow by Tarte. This one's in medium brown, but I really like this as well. It has a super, super small applicator, but it works really good. It has little fibers in it, and I really, really like the combination of these two. So then the last kind of makeup stuff that I have is lip stuff. So I have four different go-to lip products. So first is the Physicians Formula Healthy Lip. This is in All Natural Nude. This is like one of my favorite nudes. It's just, it's like a little bit pinker than I'm used to. I usually wear a nude that's a little bit more brown than this, but it is pretty pink. But I do really like it. It's like it's a velvet finish, they call it, and I would call it exactly that. And when I wear this and pretty much anything else, I like to top it with the Dose of Colors Brillo lip gloss from the I Love Sari and Dose collection. I also just ordered Over the Top from the Desi X Katie collection, and I am so, so excited. I also ordered the palette, but my mom bought me the palette and I won't get that until Christmas, but I needed the Over the Top gloss. I was like, I'll buy it now, whatever. Ulta, I know, is getting it on Friday or on Sunday, so that is so exciting because that's where I work, so I'll be able to get the rest of the collection. I'll probably get the entire collection, honestly, because I am, my favorite YouTubers, my favorite people on YouTube are Desi and Katie. They're just so cool and so amazing, and I love their collection. I missed out on their first one, and I am so excited to get every single thing in this one. But anyway, back to this. Brillo is just like a glittery top gloss. So I put that pretty much over everything. And then for a little bit deeper of a color, this is YSL. This is the Couture Matte Stain in 28. Again, same best friend, my best friend Katie. Every time she comes over, she wears this out. And it's just like a deep mauve nude. I still call it nude, like in the nude family. On the lips, it looks a little bit lighter than it looks on my hand. And then if I want to wear a red, again, this is Dose, and I love, it's Fressa. And it's like a little bit of a different red for me. It's a little bit more vibrant. I usually wear like a really blue red, but this has like a little bit of orange in it. It almost looks coral, but I really like the way that this looks on. And like I said, it's a little bit different for me, but I ended up really liking it. So those have been my top four kind of go-to lip products in the last month or so. So then moving on to skincare, my absolute favorite skincare product. If you're gonna spend money on one skincare product, it should be this. And this is the Peter Thomas Roth Firm X Peeling Gel Exfoliant. My friend Christine showed this to me and I am obsessed with it. It's like kind of expensive. It's in like the $40-$50 range, but it is so amazing. So it takes all like the product buildup off your skin. It's like a gel, and this is not going to be able to be seen, but let's try. So it's like a gel, and when you rub it in, it like beads up. I know that it's like probably impossible to see, but it like beads up. You could see down here, and takes all the product off your skin, all the like dead skin and stuff that's on there. And it's like kind of gross, but it is so amazing. I have seen such a difference in my skin using this. It's like a visible difference. Like you could see like a luminosity. I felt that my dry skin was going away. It really helps to take that dry skin off, that layer off before you put on makeup. And it is just absolutely unbelievably amazing and so worth it. My next product that I absolutely love that is expensive as well, but so worth it. The only downfall is I feel that I'm like going through this so fast, but this is the Murad Nutrient Charged Water Gel, and it is just that. It is like a amazing water gel. My skin that has never been able to be like quenched, and I have never found something that can really hydrate my skin for a long period of time. Like it might hydrate it for a little while. This is like all day moisture, all day everything. Like this is unbelievable. And I went to a training on some of their other stuff, and they literally told us this line keeps you hydrated for like 3 or 5 days, whether you put it on or not. But this is amazing. This is absolutely unbelievably amazing. And last thing I think for skincare is this Mario Badescu Herbal Hydrating Serum. So you put this on after your moisturizer, and this is just an extra step for people who have super, super dry skin. Which is what I have. It's like this hot blue color, and it's just like a gel serum. So serums to me, they kind of, for my skin at least, they kind of clog my pores, and I just feel like I break out or I get texture from them. This does not do that at all, I guess because it's a little bit thicker. It's not like that oil that kind of seeps in to like your pores and stuff. I feel that putting it over a moisturizer works great, and I am really, really happy with how the results of this have been turning out. I'm gonna move on to my hair products. One of them is a favorite, and it's like kind of weird because I just bought it, but I'll explain. This is the Living Proof No Frizz Instant Defrizzer. I just bought my own bottle, but my friend Christine, when we went to Aruba, I tried it a bunch of times, and like Aruba's so windy and like your hair is everywhere and could be so frizzy, and we used this and I truly believe that it helped tame my hair while I was there. So I'm like, if I can tame it in Aruba can tame it in New York. So, yeah, and it's softness and shine and all different things, but it's like a dry conditioner, but I really like the way that it worked for me when I was away, and so I thought, why not? I'll buy it, and I've been using it a few days, and I remember why I loved it. So, yeah. Then I have a hair mask. This is the Chlorine Nutri Reparation. It's like a, I forget what it smells like. Mask with desert date, dry, damaged, and brittle hair. Half this stuff is not in English. But it's just like a tub of hair mask. I just got water on here because it was in my shower. Smells nice. It kind of smells like a little like nutty. I don't know if there's nuts in this or anything. But kind of smells a little nutty. And I like other hair masks. Like I love the macadamia one, but this one's really, really nice. It doesn't bother my color treated hair. Like I don't feel it's stripping my hair of the color. And I don't feel like it's stripping my hair of like natural oils or anything, but I think it does a really good job hydrating it. It's not super thick. It's a little bit more watery than other masks, but I do really like it. Then finally, my holy grail shower product. I brought this whole bottle with me when I went to Aruba, when I went to Nashville. This keeps my hair blonde. So this is the Caracolor Color Plus Conditioner in Platinum. So it cleanses and conditions, deposits color pigment, and brightens dull blondes, and it has like pictures on the back and stuff. But my hair right now, like you could obviously see my roots coming in, but my color, this preserves my color, this lightens my color. Like this is just the best thing if you have blonde hair and you want like a little bit of ash to it and you don't want any gold or yellow or anything, this is what you need to use. This is the best product for blonde hair, I think, in my opinion. And it is super moisturizing, almost too moisturizing sometimes. But yeah, I leave it on basically like a mask. I put it in after I shampoo my hair. I just kind of like lightly shampoo my hair. You don't really have to, apparently, but I always shampoo my hair. But I'll do like a little bit of a lighter rinse, and then I'll put this in and I'll put it from like right about here down. Make sure that like I really get in the middle and the ends and stuff. And I leave this in for like five, seven minutes, and I see a result every single time that I dry my hair. Like every time I get out of the shower and I use this, I see a difference in my hair. So this keeps the brass out, this keeps the yellow out, everything, and it is the best thing for color treated blonde hair. Okay, so the final things that I'm gonna show are songs that are my favorite, and I'm just gonna play like a little snippet of it because copyright and all that. So my only non-country favorite is I Wanna Know by NOTD featuring Bay Miller. And this is like my going out song. My favorite song lately is You Ain't Here to Kiss Me by Brett Young. I am a huge Brett Young fan. And I just think he's amazing and someone definitely broke his heart and I just love him. Such a beautiful song, everything he does. I've never heard a Brett Young song I don't think that I didn't like. Morgan Evans' Day Drunk always makes me want to drink, honestly. Morgan Evans is really cool. His song Kiss Somebody is also really good. I love Carrie Underwood's new album. I always love everything she does. Also, I love the song Drunk Me by Mitchell Tenpenny. Such a good song. Such a good song. That's like his EP, so the end of summer was a huge Zac Brown summer for me. I went to Zac Brown Band in the end of July, I guess. And then they played so many Zac Brown songs in Aruba, and I love Knee Deep featuring Jimmy Buffett, As She's Walking Away, Toes, obviously, Loving You Easy, Homegrown, they're all great. This is mine and my mom's favorite song. This is a Keith Urban song. It's called Break On Me. This is our favorite part. Such a good song. It is not on his set list, and we are going to see him October 27th, and my mom is very, very disappointed. My Keith Urban story is that I posted like a picture on my Instagram while I was in Nashville, and it was like in front of the graffiti U-wall, and I posted like the comment that I made, said like Keith Urban might be coming home because his song Coming Home, but I don't know if I ever am. And I got a message from his Instagram saying, can we use this on our story? And I said, yes, of course. And then I was on Keith Urban's Instagram story while I was in Nashville. So, pretty cool. Dan and Shay got some bomb songs right now. They're not necessarily new, but Alone Together, great song. So that one's super good. Speechless or what's it called? Speechless or For the Ground Up, I already decided I want to be my wedding songs. Blue Tacoma by Russell Dickerson. Another great one. Alright, I got one more after this. I could go on all day about country songs, but and Love Somebody by Brett Eldridge. After seeing Brett Eldridge, so a lot of these people, when I went to CMA Fest, I saw, so I got to live my dream of like seeing all these people. I'm seeing Keith again because he was so amazing. The only ones that I'm missing, kinda, is I wanna see Jason Aldean. I missed him the first night because I went to see Blake Shelton at the Grand Ole Opry. And Jason Aldean and Kenny Chesney. Kenny Chesney did his tour with Thomas Rhett that I'm so upset that I missed, but again, Aruba, and like Aruba definitely outweighed the concert. So, Rhett. Love Rhett. I also missed his concert on Long Island, but. So that is it for my favorites, for my under summer, September, and like September favorites. I hope you guys enjoyed this. It's a little bit different for me. But thank you guys if you made it to the end, and I'll see you in my next video, and please like and subscribe if you haven't already.